Just walk right out the door. Don't want to do this anymore. Now I'm lost without you. You drive me crazy out my mind. How'd you do this every time? Now I'm lost without you. Used to be the one I talk to when I'm sad. Can't you see now tainted love is all we have? Issues run so deep, now when I try to sleep, I feel so bad. I should leave, and by the time it's done, I'll be gone.
Alright, seems that my stream is working. Just checking. Hey, hi Squishy Hero, hi Determined Hero, and good evening everyone. It's nighttime here in the Philippines, and today we're gonna unbox the Nightmare Before Christmas ColourPop collection. So, I am so sorry, I haven't been online in a long time. No worries, I figured I would share with you, you with my friends. Aw, thank you so much, really do appreciate it. Yeah, I'm gonna try to be more active this December just because it's the holiday break. But about last August, which is where I started becoming more inactive in stream or on stream, what I haven't updated to everyone was I've started taking up Nihongo classes. Which friends are those? So yeah, I've I've started taking up Nihongo classes, so that made me busy. So on weekdays, on top of my work, I have to do a lot of pre-work for my Nihongo class, which is about 4 to 5 hours every Saturdays and Sundays. And actually, I still have my Nihongo class. It's just that today I took a leave from work just so I can kind of power down a little bit. Plus, I need to use my leaves anyway. So, I just kind of want to have a long weekend. And so, I finally found a time to go online. But other than that, for the past couple of months, for the past 4 months, it's really been tough. Oh, hey, Squishy Hero. Thank you so much for the raid. I'm not... Because I've turned off my speakers just because it's having a feedback again. I can't hear any notification. I should, like... I've put it in my earphones, the sound for my... Anyway. It's just weird. Whenever I do the speaker mode or whenever I use the speaker mode, there's a feedback. I gotta research on that. Just because... It's really throwing me for a loop. The feedback is coming out on stream and it just doesn't sound very well. It feels like, or it actually sounds like my voice is coming way down from the well. Anyway. So, yeah, that's it about me. And recently, I've actually just finished the first level of Nihongo, but I've enrolled in 2 Nihongo classes, N5 and N4. So right after N5, we just proceeded with N4, and in fact, we just started last Sunday for our first N4 class. Way down from the well. Like, just the echo is really terrible. Yeah, anyway, so for today, I don't know if I'll have time for the games. I assume this is gonna be a quick unboxing, not unless I decided to make a look. So for today, what we're gonna be doing is unboxing ColourPop's Nightmare Before Christmas collection. And I'm gonna go ahead and do some swatches. Right after that, we are going to try. If there's more time, I'm gonna try to make a look, but I can't promise. If not, we're just gonna proceed to play games. I'm not sure which game to play yet. Recently, I've only been playing Age of Empires. And then Genshin Impact just a little bit you know, just to do dailies and stuff, but nothing more. I've had so much backlogs in Genshin Impact. I don't even know if I'll be able to catch up story-wise. I'm like 3 stories behind in Genshin Impact. So that's a bit of a problem for me. And yes, Age of Empire 3. Not even Age of Empire 4. Because it went on sale during the Steam sale Halloween. And so I was able to buy it for cheap. And I'm having fun with it. Alright. Anyway, without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and start opening up this ColourPop collection. So here's the story. They've actually released this October 29th or October 30th, just right before the Halloween. And I was super worried because they did not even have any pre-marketing over it. They just posted that, oh, we have a Christmas, a Nightmare Before. Thanks, Determined Hero. Back in, what's this? 2 months. Was it 2 months ago? No, about a month ago. More than a month ago. October 28th. Like before, a little bit before that, they've actually just posted it in their Instagram account. And then, oh, I said, this is cool. I don't know how popular A Nightmare Before Christmas it is, but I really like the aesthetic of Nightmare Before Christmas. I'm not gonna say that I'm a huge fan of Nightmare Before Christmas, but I watch it every now and then. I like it so much. I have a couple of Jack Skellington and Sally toys, like the Nendoroids and a couple of Chibis and Funko Pops. Yeah, I know. I love Tim Burton art. So, yeah. So anyway, they've just, like, there's no pre-marketing. Usually for ColourPop, for big collaborations, like for example the Sailor Moon collection, they send out the package to different influencer before the actual release, just to create the hype. But for this one, they actually did not. So anyway, I don't know how popular it is. Unlike for Sailor Moon, the first time I tried ordering, it was sold out a couple of minutes after it was released in their website. So I was pretty bummed about that. I actually did not get a complete collection of the Sailor Moon palette or the Sailor Moon collection. I only got the palette, the Super Shock, one blush. Oh, shoot, I did not even get a blush. I just got the lipstick. And then that's just about it. Hey, Determined Hero, I just noticed, sorry, my notification came out late. So both Squishy Hero and Determined Hero, you guys rated me. Thank you so much. Anyway, for those people who are new on my stream. Hi, Tiny Christy, oh my god, I miss you. I've been taking Nihongo classes. I just finished N5 and we proceeded right after N5, no break. We proceeded right straight to N4 and it was rad, like, oh, so crazy. I haven't had the time to decongest or decompress whatever I've learned from N5, and now we're proceeding to N4, so wow. Too much information in my head, but I've been like super, you know, for the past couple of months it's been tough for me just because busy with work, busy with too much work in my Nihongo class. So I felt like I'm N4, we just started yesterday, actually. We just finished N5. So far, okay. I'm not super satisfied with my N4 sensei, with my N4 teacher. So I don't know. I'm not really feeling it so far. N5, I had a great time with N5. It was really fun. N4, I'm not super married to it yet, just because I have my apprehension towards the teacher. And I don't know if I should say that in public, but anyway, it's in my stream. It's my stream anyway, so I think I can say whatever the hell I want. Oh, that sucks. Oh, but how's your Nihongo class? Are you done with your Nihongo class? there's no JLPT exam for in the Philippines this year. I don't know if we'll be able to take it by next year though. And I'm worried that by the time the JLPT exams resumes, it's going to be a problem because I've already forgotten a lot. What the heck? Why did she get a high price cheer and I got... Anyway, for everyone who are new in my stream, good evening. My name is Lady Faladriel. I'm from the Philippines and I normally stream RPG games. Right now though, we're not gonna stream, we're not gonna play games, or I might, depending on my mood, because I'm quite moody. But yeah, today we're gonna unbox the Nightmare Before Christmas ColourPop collection. Oh, okay. So yeah, I was very happy with my N5 class. I enrolled in Lyceum Makati. Because they had a promo back then, N5 plus N4, it's a package. So that's why after N5, we just went straight to N4. But they had to change our sensei for the N4 class. And I'm a little bit... I have my apprehension. Yeah. Well, try Lyceum. I mean, the sensei right now, I'm not happy. But I heard good stuff about the other senseis. I'm gonna be lurking. Oh, okay. Take care, Squishy Hero. Thank you so much for dropping by. Yeah, I know. I'll try my best to be more active. I swear to God, I'm trying my best. Anyway, going back to my story of the ColourPop. This is quite a bit of a ride for me. Yes. Go ahead and check. And I feel like they have competitive price. Even Squishy got emo- I'm so sorry, the Termin Hero. Don't worry, stick around and you'll get more emotions. Here, I'm gonna give you my dab. Yeah, anyway, going back to my story. I think the Termin Hero, when you were chatting away, I was like telling the story about the ColourPop collection. So that's why, this is quite a bit of a ride for me because during the Halloween sale, ColourPop had a free shipping sale, or a free shipping promo. So I got my collection, I bought the whole collection for free shipping, and they even offer it internationally, which really amazed me. But it took a month before I actually received the package. So I ordered it the moment it got released because I was super scared that it's gonna go out similar to the Sailor Moon collection. Apparently, there's not a lot of hype. Although it is pretty much sold out now, there's only like the palette left in ColourPop if you're gonna check their website. Yeah, it's fine. I had to troll. Yeah. I know, I missed you guys. Aww, I really wanted to go on stream. It's just that really, life gets in the way. Aw, I hate life. it took a month. I received it November, somewhere late November. Hi, Star Creek. Thank you so much, Sir Louis, for dropping by. I just started my stream. We're gonna have a VC later, diba? So I'm gonna see you later. So yeah, I received this like a month later, and when I got it, I was pretty impressed because usually, one of my fears ordering online, especially direct from, I usually would get a third party shipping service so that I don't have to go through customs or our post office. Because usually there's a huge tax involved, especially if it goes through customs. So I was like super scared to order directly from a shop. But I did because ColourPop offered an international free shipping. So amazing. That's why big shout out. I really love ColourPop. They might not be, you know, a high end. They're actually on the more affordable side when it comes to cosmetics, but their services are really good, and plus they have really cool collaboration and their eye palette's so good. So anyway, there's not a lot of hype. It wasn't like Sailor Moon where it was, you know, it was sold out for the first couple of minutes on their first batch of release. This one, I was able to get the whole collection right after I pre-ordered it. And it kind of stayed there, the whole collection kind of stayed there for quite a while, for a couple of weeks if I'm not mistaken, before it actually got sold out. And the reason behind that is because when influencers checked, they were already commenting when ColourPop posted it online in Instagram, they were happy with the palette, most especially. They were hoping that it's more adventurous in terms of, you know, the colors that ColourPop offered in this palette. Because, hey, it's Nightmare Before Christmas, right? So, you really have to be, whatchamacallit, you know, you're kind of looking for something that's more bold. This one, I wouldn't say it's subtle, or it's not exactly in the neutral territory, but at least it's not as bold as, you know, the colors are not as bold as what the influencers or what cosmetic lovers are hoping for a Nightmare Before Christmas collection. Hence, it did not get the hype that I was dreading for, or I was dreading on. So that being said, let's go ahead and start opening up the Nightmare Before Christmas. I'm gonna start with the Zero. Whatchamacallit? This is a blending sponge. So I don't know if I'm ever gonna use this blending sponge, just because it's super cute. I've seen the pictures. I haven't really opened up the collection. Some of them are even on their bubble wraps. But I've seen some pictures. So this one is pretty cool. And by the way, this is my new unboxing setup. I am not married to this kind of setup. I was in a hurry earlier. I said I really wanted to do an unboxing setup, because in the future I'm planning to unbox toys or even like build Legos and stuff while streaming. So that's what I'm planning to do. I'm not super married with this kind of setup yet. I am probably gonna need a couple of more right accessory for my other camera. Probably I'm gonna need a better tripod for this. This tripod, I'm not super happy with it. It doesn't have the height that I need for a flat layout. Yeah, please look forward to it. I have a lot of toys that I haven't unboxed yet, because I said I want to unbox them during stream, but you know, got busy. But yeah, I'm not super married. The camera is so far away from me. I wish it's closer. I wish it's higher, it's taller, and I need a longer cable for it to connect to the CPU, because right now the cable that I got a Fujifilm camera X-T200. Some of you might probably have seen it in my Instagram account when I posted it. Whatchamacallit? The box has a cable, but the cable is super short, so I might need to buy a longer cable. So it's a little bit awkward, because I have to position it very close to the CPU so that it connects to the CPU. But yes, take a look at this. But hey, nice camera, eh? See, I'm having problems with the orientation. Ah, there you go. Come on, there. Ah, focus, please. See, this is super hard. This is a super hard setup, I swear to God. There. So that is the Canon Ridge, thank you so much for the follow. Hi, my name is Lady Falatriel, and currently, or today, we're gonna do, or we're doing an unboxing for the Nightmare Before Christmas collection. So yeah, there you go. This is the Zero Blending Sponge. I am dyslexic, so yeah, my orientation is always weird. This is so cute. In terms of how the sponge is, it's kind of firm but squishy at the same time. By the way, I am not a cosmetic expert, just to give you a heads up, guys. I'm not a cosmetic expert by any means. Right now, I don't even have a lot on my face. I just have like a liquid lipstick. Oh, thank you. This is my pajama. Because after stream, I'm gonna get ready to sleep. This is a twin star pajama. So anyway, yeah. It does have a little bit of glitter to it. It's not very obvious in the camera, but there are glitters. They are, what's this? The glitters are sparsely spreaded in the blending sponge, but you get them on your hands. If ever you touch this, you get them on your hands, so just a fair warning. But it's really cute. I don't even know if I'm gonna use this blending sponge, to be honest, because it's my collection. I'm gonna just keep it for collection purposes. So there you go, that's the Zero Blending Sponge. I'm gonna do that last. Next up, if anything, I'm not a makeup person, to be completely honest. I have some makeups that I normally would lean towards too. Like for example, lipstick, I always wear lipstick. And the other thing is that more than lipsticks, I can go out of the house without lipstick, but a lot of times, or most often than not, I cannot go out without wearing an eyeliner. So I am super happy that ColourPop actually put out two eyeliners for this collection. And this is how they look like. The boxes, by the way, the boxes look really nice. Some of them have this texture feel to them. Like for example, I don't know if you guys can see it can be seen on the stream, but there are those, they kind of look like snowflakes, but black snowflakes, and they're glittered, so it's really cool. I love the texture in these boxes. The boxes are really well thought out. So the two eyeliners are called BFF Liquid. Oh, they're called BFF Liquid Liner. I came into this without knowing the names. I'm so sorry. So the Sally liner is called Scream Queen. I think this is the white one, and the black is the Jack Skellington. The Jack Skellington is the Pumpkin King. So yeah, there you go. It's really cool. We're gonna do the swatches right now. I'm gonna open it up. So let's start with the Scream Queen. This is in collaboration with Disney as well. I don't know if you've watched in Netflix, but Nightmare Before Christmas was featured in the holiday movies that made history or something. So originally Disney did not want to get the Tim Burton movies. And it was Nightmare Before Christmas was actually originally published by Tim Burton. Just because the art itself is not very Disney, right? Because you will see the Tim Burton art is a little bit more goth. But I super love it. Yeah, the box design looks very cool. I super love it. Wait, it's a little bit hard to open up. I am worried to damage the box, so that's why I'm super careful in opening it up. I don't think it's gonna survive though. Every time I do this, every time whenever I need to open this or use... No, the box is gonna get ruined. there's already a tear over there. And I'm very particular with the box. By the way, for the eyeliner, there's the bunny logo in here for cosmetic lovers. You know that this is cruelty free, so pretty much if you are looking for cosmetics that are cruelty free, ColourPop is cruelty free makeup. This is, oh my god, it's so cute. I mean, I've seen pictures, but it actually looks nice in person. This is the design for the Scream Queen. There you go. I am also a huge fan of Dia de Muertos. For those of you who don't know, I'm actually also into photography. One of my favorite shoot that I ever did was in collaboration with a friend who likes to do makeups. She also models for herself. So she did, we've come up, it was my idea and she, you know, made it happen. Like, she did a makeup for Calavera. So that's the theme, it's Dia de Muertos. It's one of my favorite shoots ever. So I'm into these types of design, really. So that's why I'm super excited when ColourPop released the Nightmare Before Christmas collection. Oh, this one opened a little bit easier than the Scream Queen. I didn't have any problems with this. And, oh, the Jack Salentine is black and white. I kind of like the design of the Sally. It's so weird. This setup is so weird. It's throwing me off, like, which camera should I use? This camera or this camera? But yeah, this is how they look like. I'm kind of digging the pink more than the black and white. Now, I just don't know which one is the white. Oh, it is Jack Skellington that's the white eyeliner. Then it's actually the Sally that's the black eyeliner. Right there. Yeah, it's nice. So, just to give you an idea how it looks like. Okay, that is nice. Alright, this is how the eyeliner looks like. The black is solid. It has a little bit of sheen to it. It's not a matte eyeliner, so if you're looking for a matte eyeliner, this is not it. It has a bit of a sheen to it. The white is also pretty solid. Not as solid as the black one, but hey, it's visible. Look at that. So I think this is a pretty good white eyeliner. I had a bit of apprehension. I have apprehensions when it comes to white eyeliner just because sometimes they're not as good. This one, by the way, it's not a quick dry. Oh, it is pretty much dry now. But once you line them up, you will feel that it is a little bit wet at first. So you kind of have to dry it for a little bit. It dries up pretty quickly though. Yay, I'm glad that you guys like the pink design because it's really super good. And it is the black eyeliner. I usually would go for just, you know, black eyeliner. I would love to be more adventurous when it comes to eyeliners. It's just that I have bad experiences before. I did buy a white eyeliner before from Flow Fushi. That's the top one eyeliner back in the days when I went to Japan. I researched about their cosmetic in Japan. If there's any country that can do good when it comes to eyeliner, that's Japan. Mark my word for it. And their best eyeliner at that time is Flow Fushi. So I bought it's a little bit on the expensive side. It's around 1,200 yen. That's around $12. I should get the prices for this, right? I don't have the price at the top of my list. Let's see, at the top of my head. Let's see if ColourPop has it. Let's check my order history. Great job for me for coming into the stream without any format at all. So yeah, the whole collection. Oh no, it's not individually marked. I don't think I can get the price anymore. Unfortunately, I can't get the link for the individual prices, and some of these items are already sold out, so I really can't find the price. But the whole price for the collection is $115, just so you have an idea how much it is. But let me check here if I can still get the prices for these. I wish there's a price list. ちょっと待ってください。 Harder to find the prices than I thought. Let me see here. Alright, there you go. So for the BFF eyeliners, this is $10 each. The Flow Fushi that I got before was 1,200 yen, so that's around $12. This one, $10 each. So that's the Nightmare Before Christmas BFF eyeliners. Really good, I love it. I'm gonna use it definitely. I'm definitely gonna use the black one more than I will use the white one. I just don't know, these are for specific occasion. But when I bought the Flow Fushi eyeliner before, I was super in love with their black eyeliner. It's a matte eyeliner. I love matte eyeliners. It's not easy to get them. They're kind of on the pricier side. At least the ones that I'm seeing, they're kind of on the pricier side. The cheaper ones, really more of them are, you know, would have a sheen to them. But I love a good black matte eyeliner. Flow Fushi is one of them. I also bought their white one just to test it. And I was super disappointed because when I opened it, it was dried up. It dried up pretty quickly, so I wasn't happy with it. And it's not really working towards my skin. It's not really giving me a solid white line like this one. This one's giving me a solid white line, so I'm pretty happy with it. Yep, love their eyeliner. This is actually the first time I'm trying a ColourPop eyeliner. I'm pretty happy with it. Maybe in the future I'll buy more eyeliners from ColourPop. They come in, ColourPop sells eyeliners in different colors, and I might try them. All right. On to the next one. This one, if you've watched Nightmare Before Christmas, you for sure know these Trio of Terror. Yeah. They've made me laugh a lot. I feel like they're really one of those they're the comic relief of the movie. Yeah, of course, you know, Jack Skellington is always fun to watch, but this Trio of Terror, they're really the comic relief of the movie. Similar to the box of the BFF eyeliner, this also has some texture to it. The designs are pretty much similar. You can see those black snowflakes, and they are glittered, and they are actually, you can feel the texture. The design is really super good. So we have here, these are Jelly Much Shadow Trio. So we have Lock, Shock, and Barrel. I love these three kids. They are fun to watch. Let's see here. Any information though? Yeah, this is also has the cruelty-free logo. I think pretty much all of ColourPop's cosmetics are cruelty-free. And when you open it up, ta-da! I should have opened it up here, right? When I push this, ta-da! This is how they look like! And when I... Let's see here. Let's take out one. So this one's locked. Please orient properly. This one's locked. What color is lock? Lock is, it doesn't say what color is lock, but let's open it up. So this is pretty much a plastic cover, and then, is this glass? No, it's a plastic, but it is a pretty plastic, it is a pretty thick plastic jar. If I had those, I'd probably keep the box or cut. Yeah, exactly. Like, I'm gonna keep them for sure. I'm a huge box collector. All of my people were telling me, hey, Dana, buy a cabinet or a display cabinet for your toys, blah, blah, blah. But actually, my toys are not displayed. They're in the box because I keep the boxes. So anyway, let's open her up. Ooh. This is how it looks like. There's like a thin plastic cover. Actually, it's not very thin. It's a solid plastic cover. That is shock. I don't know what color is this. Do I have any information on that? The jelly eyeshadow, the Trio jelly eyeshadow. I've actually never tried a jelly eyeshadow before from ColourPop. I heard before that it's a hit and miss, but ColourPop did change their formula on the jelly. It is a little bit better now. That's what I've heard from influencers who are featuring jelly jelly eyeshadow. So I am a bit on the fence if I should open it up, just because I don't know how much will I use it. So the trio jelly shadow, the Jelly Much Shadow Trio is $10 each. So this is $10 each. If you want to get the whole box, does it mean that it's $30? Okay. So there is a thin plastic cover. I did open her up. Can't resist. Oh, so that's how it feels like. And this is how it's hard to do it in there. I don't know if I'm not pushing it in. It's jelly, so you know. It feels a little bit funky. It feels like a very soft Play-Doh. Like a wet, soft Play-Doh. It's the first time I've tried it. Wait, let me get... Okay, there you go. You have to push it a little bit in. Put some pressure when you are trying to... It's hard! Okay, I'm just gonna have to rely on this one. So this is how it looks like. You have to put the pressure for you to get the pigmentation that you want. For this eyeshadow, I am not sure if you can use a brush for this eyeshadow though. I've never really played with this type of eyeliner. I don't even know if this is the right brush to use, but I'm gonna use this. Is this called a tapered brush from Wet n Wild? Oh, I think it's best to use it. This is how it looks like when I use the brush. Maybe you have to wet the brush or just use your fingers when you're using a jelly eyeshadow. It is a little bit funky for me. So yeah, this is how it looks like when I'm using the brush. It is a little bit funky. But hey, I love the color. The color is nice. It is like a dark, like a blue. It is a black shadow for sure. It is a black eyeshadow for sure, but it has those blue glitters to them. So it kind of reminds me of Midnight, to be honest. So it gives me that midnight effect wherein it's black, but then again it has those blue glitters to them. It also has kind of that blue tint to the black shadow itself. It's really cool. It reminds me of midnight. So there you go. It looks blue in here, right? It looks navy blue. It looks like the midnight. But when you swipe it, it has that black color to it. I don't know how much will I use these black, this shadow jelly. I don't know how to use it. Oh, jeez. The next one is Shock. So this is how it looks like. There. And when I open it up, it also has the plastic. Surprisingly, it is pink. Hey, Tenshi World, what's up? No time, no see. It is a pink eyeshadow, jelly eyeshadow. Surprisingly, I was thinking that it was Beryl who's gonna be pink, but it is actually Shock that's pink in color. Very busy, Tenshi World. I started, I don't know if I mentioned this to you already when during my last stream, but I am taking Nihongo classes. I'm still taking them now, so even my weekends are preoccupied. Let's try her up. You really have to get in there. So that's, is it easier if I do it in here? Let me try that again. I think it's easier if I do it here. There you go. Boy, that is pigmented. How are you, Tenshi World? Okay, I don't know how much will I use this eyeshadow similar to... Yeah, I know, it's a makeup stream. It is an unboxing stream because I'm a huge fan of ColourPop collection. So I'm trying out the Nightmare Before Christmas collection. Oh, good luck on your exam! I just finished mine last week, so I had my finals in Nihongo Level 5 in N5. I did pass it, so now I'm moving on to N4. Or I moved on to N4 because our N4 started last Sunday. So this one is hot pink. I am not much of a pink user. I know I'm wearing a pink shirt right now, but I'm more on the baby pink side rather than the hot pink side. The Nightmare Before Christmas is a lot of hot pink color, but loving the I love the glitter. The glitter, it has that purplish glitter to them. It almost make it look like holographic, so I find that really cool. It's a little bit hard to do that here on the other camera. I really need a better Seriously, I really need a better, a better tripod for this. I need a tripod that will allow me to do a flat lay so that when I do this, it kind of shows the, you know, my arm here on top. So far, my Japanese is just self-learned. Self-learned is fine. It's kind of good. It's gonna be hard to do, like, you know... It's hard to self-study, I feel like. For me personally, I feel like it's gonna be hard to self-study. When you wanna be more fluent in Japanese. And here's the thing. Not unless you're familiar with their culture, sure. Or you know a Japanese yourself, a Japanese person yourself. It's gonna be hard because some of their senses are kind of in context. It's funny because I had a training last October and it is a Japanese class. So we actually have... Oh, look at that. I did that here on my palm. And it's also pretty nice, even if it's a sheen swipe. It is pretty nice on sheen. got me getting distracted. I never had a psychiatrist check me, but I have a feeling I have an ADD or ADHD. I get distracted so easily. Hi, Coopsmander, how are ya? So anyway, in my story, I had this Japanese class last October, I think. And we had an interpreter, so I couldn't like speak in Japanese yet. So I'm training in English, but then again, there's an interpreter. So I was telling her, because I was greeting them in Japanese, because I can't greet in Japanese, like "Ohayou gozaimasu, hajimemashou ka." And then they were like super happy with me like speaking in Japanese from time to time. They saying, "Oh, you speak Japanese very good." And then I was telling them, "No, I started out taking Nihongo classes, and I'm just, you know, at the very start back then." I was just like halfway through my N5 class. So, you know, they were telling me, "Oh, good luck. Japanese is muzukashii ne?" And then in English, she was saying that Japanese is hard, right? And then I said, "Yeah, it is a little bit hard. Muzukashii. Hai, hondo da. Muzukashii kara muzukashii ga muzukashii desu." I can't remember what my exact words are, but what I'm basically telling is that muzukashii ne, demo ne, hondo ni omoshiroi desu. So I'm basically saying that, you know, Japanese is quite hard, but then again, it's really interesting to learn. And it is really interesting to learn. And then even even the interpreter herself said to me, good luck, because sometimes our language can be quite vague. You have to learn the context of what you're really talking about for you to get a full understanding of, you know, what they're saying, because there are some words that are very similar but they differ in spelling, so they differ in characters, but they will be pronounced the same. So depending on your use for that particular word, then the meaning might be different. Hi, muzukashii desu. Hi. and then a funny thing is that she said that, "Oh, learning Japanese is hard," and then eventually, as you learn more, as you progress in your class, it's gonna get harder and harder. Wow, way to motivate me. And it's been quite a while. It's been busy for me. It's really been tough for the past. My feeling for the past couple of months, to be honest, it felt like, you know, when you are kind of swimming in a very deep pool, like. You know, I'm 5'2" in height, but I feel like I'm swimming on a eight feet deep pool, and you're kind of struggling to keep yourself afloat. That's exactly how I'm feeling. At this point, it's hard to imagine. I know, yeah, N1. Oh my god, I can't even imagine myself going to N3 at this point. So for those who don't know, there are five levels of Japanese language. When you're studying them, I don't know, Japanese don't go through this because they have a different way of learning. But for foreigners, if you kind of want to learn Japanese, there are five levels. It goes from N5 going to N1. N5 is sort of the introduction, and then it gets tougher and tougher as we go along. I'm sure you can make it. Thank you, Tenshi World. So moving on to the very last Jelly Eyeshadow, this is Barrel. Aww. So Barrel is brown? I think it's dark bronze. I am bad with colors, you guys. But this is kind of a dark bronze color, right? I don't know where to place this. So it is kind of a dark bronze color. Let's swipe her up. Or him up. Barrel is a guy. Keep on forgetting. I don't know how well it may register in my skin, just because, you know, I'm Morena. I'm chocolate skin. So it doesn't register that well in my skin. How does it look like? Oh, it actually is kind of nice. I know, I'm bad at colors, I swear to God. for me, I wouldn't call it bronze. For me, it's more brown in color. And this one almost feels nude for me just because, you know, I'm brown skinned. So that's why it's kind of a nude color for me. But in reality, it is brown with purplish flecks of glitters. I think all of them have those bluish and purplish flecks of glitters. But this one, the pink has the more purplish glitter. The midnight color has more of a blue flecks to them. And this one more have like those gold tiny flecks on them with a little bit of a purple. So that's the color for Barrel. Oh man, I'm getting drippy on my nose. I think I have an allergy. I changed my sheets yet last night, and I think that kind of triggered my allergy. So I've been having a runny nose. Anyway, my review on the Jelly Eyeshadow. If you guys... It's funny because a lot of my viewers are boys, so I don't know if you guys will appreciate this, but for girls, if you want to have that wet look, the Jelly Eyeshadow gives you that wet look, actually. Especially the Barrel. Barrel gives me a very wet look right now. It's giving me a very wet look right now. But the most pigmented one? The pink one. Which is, I forget the name. Shock. Shock is the pink Jelly Eyeshadow. Let me just go ahead and erase this so that we can move on to the next one, which, ooh, lipstick. I'm gonna save the... But I'm not a makeup expert, though. I only... Oh, shoot! I tried to clean it up with my makeup wipe, and the glitter just went all over. How can I do my swatches, though, for the eye palette? Holy crap! Okay, I don't know if that was a huge mistake on my part. By the way, Tenshi World and Koopsmander, I was saying earlier during the start of my stream that I'm also... this is gonna be my unboxing setup. I'm not fully married to the idea that this is gonna be it. I want a better... tripod for this. I don't know what tripod to actually buy for me to get that flat look on the surface, because I'm planning to do toy unboxing and Lego creations. So that's what I'm planning to do in the future, if only I can find the time. So hey, I did the best I can, but I'm filled with glitters. I am using Fujifilm X-T200. This is the X-T200 right now. It looks really nice. I super love it. I am not sure when I'm gonna use this. Oops, that's not the right way. But hey, I'm keeping this for my collection. This is the Trio of Terror Jelly Eyeshadow. Okay, the next one that I am going to unbox. These are the lipsticks. So we have here the Oogie Boogie. This is a, all of these are cream luxe lipsticks. So Oogie Boogie, this is how it looks like. This is how it looks like. Right, it's super cute. And then when you turn around, this is how the back of the lipstick box looks like. And you know what's fun about this? Oh, it opened up on its own. Huh. You know what's fun about this? It has this string over here. It makes me think that you can actually display this on your Christmas tree. And maybe, you know, if you want to be interactive, if you want to give this away, you can, like, make a game or do a game during Christmas. And the winner, like, gets this from the Christmas tree. If you want to have, like, fun during Christmas, I feel like this is a good prize for, you know, like, Christmas games and stuff. So you have these, the Oogie Boogie. And then this is Sally. I'm looking for a name of the, but they're just named after the characters themselves. So this is Sally. Sally's the hot pink. I am not sure. I feel like I can use these two right here, but I don't know if I can use Sally. I've never tried hot pink on my lips. Oh, that is really cool. This art here on the side, really, really cool. I love it. All right, this is the back. I love the pink color though of the box. I just don't know if I can use a hot pink on my lips. And then lastly, we have here Jack with Zero. But this is called Jack Skellington, this particular lipstick. This is the red one, if I'm not mistaken. So I believe that Oogie Boogie is nude. Jack Skellington is red, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, let's go ahead and unbox. And since Oogie Boogie kind of opened up on his own, let's go ahead and start with Oogie Boogie. I love the box. Not the box, but the lipstick case. Look at that, it looks cute. This lipstick case is, I don't know, I'm not really... It's not like I'm following ColourPop religiously, but this is the first time I've seen this kind of box from them, or a lipstick case from them. It is, I don't know, is this called Black Frosted? It looks, it is a little transparent though. It is black and it is a little transparent. So you have here the front of the lipstick is... The Oogie Boogie design, and then nothing on the other sides though, but you can see it is semi-transparent. So I don't know if you call this like partially frosted. It has that feel to it. It is plastic, and this is how it looks like. Da-da-da-da. Look at that. Look at the design of the lipstick itself. It almost makes me feel like I don't want to use them. So yeah, I feel like I don't want to use these lipstick. It is a little bit smaller than what I'm used to with ColourPop. Time to keep our display. I know. I'm not even sure. I have a jelly eyeshadow on my foot. I don't know how did it get there, but it is in there. Chotto matte kudasai. Okay, so I was looking for a point of comparison. This is my Villains ColourPop Luxe Lipstick. I also love this packaging. This packaging is not even plastic, it's kind of aluminum. Now, just to, you know, compare the size of the two. Oh, they're pretty much the same. They're pretty much the same. Same in size. Not bad. I just thought this one is a little bit shorter for some reason, but they're actually the same. Alright, let me... Alright, so that's Oogie Boogie. I am so bad with this unboxing, maybe because really it's my setup. It's not even like straight. A little bit slanted just because the cable is really, really, really short. So I have to slant the camera or tilt the camera a little bit. So stupid. Anyway, let's move on to the Sally box or to the Sally lipstick. Holy crap, that's a little bit hard to open. Why is Sally's box, all of Sally's boxes are hard to open? Why is that? I am struggling with the Sally box again. And I super hate to damage it. Jeez Louise. Huh. Is there an easier way to actually do this? They want you to work for... I know, but why just the Sally box? I never had any issue with the other boxes, though. And I'm super scared to put force to it because I don't want to ruin the box. Okay, there you go. After some struggle, she finally opened up. Oh, that can't stand. Okay, fine. We'll just put it in there. And then we'll put Sally here. I usually just open boxes from the bottom. Yeah, I do that too. Like for my netherites, I open it from the bottom. I tried both bottom and top. The top opened quite easier. Aw, I really love the Sally art though. Like, it looks really nice. There you go. Let's open her up. This is the hot pink. look at that. Yeah, the design. I super love the design. I just don't know if I'm gonna use this color. I'm gonna swipe it later on. I'm just opening up all the three of them. And that is the Sally. I also like the pink color on this lipstick. That is Sally. And last but not the least, we have Jack Skellington. This one also easier to open on top. Yeah, I should buy. I have a knife. I have a like a cutter, like this. But I don't have a tweezer. Wait, I do. I do have a tweezer for my Gundam. It's just that it's stored somewhere. It's like, I know, it's like doing an operation. I'm big with boxes, so I don't want to ruin them. So this is the Jack Skellington design. It is black and white. Seems that Jack's theme is really black and white, and Sally's the pink and black. And this is how the collar looks like. That is a very good red. It looks like it has a cool tone to it, but you'll never know until you actually do the swipe. Now, speaking of swipes, let's do this. I can only swipe in my Logitech camera, so please bear with me. I'm gonna use my palm. Oh yeah, it definitely has a cool tone to this red lipstick. So for the knowledge of everyone, there are two types of red lipstick. One has a warmer tone, and then the other one has a cooler tone. Personally speaking, I like reds with cooler tones just because it makes my teeth whiter. So that's the main reason why I always go for cooler tones. And how does it look like on dark skin? This is it. Eh? There you go. At least that's easier to... Smart, so you save me. Yeah, that's a trick. Alright, this is not matte. This is their Luxe lipstick, so it is creamy. It is a creamy lipstick, for your information. For Luxe lipstick, I don't know if they really have Oh, there is a Luxe lipstick that's matte in color, but I think it specifically would tell you that it's a Luxe matte lipstick. But these are Luxe lipsticks, so it is on the creamier side. It glides like butter, by the way. It is super creamy. Luxe lipsticks, I don't have any issue with their formulation. It really glides like butter. So I love it. But of course, you know, before you apply it, make sure to put some TLC on your lips anyway. It's nicer to apply a lipstick when your lips are not as dry. So let's try the Sally one. Ooh, this is hot pink. Let's start first with my palm. Okay, that wasn't so bad, but that glided very smoothly. Now let's try it here. See that? It glides like butter. No problem with the with the application whatsoever. Really, really good. It is a good hot pink color. Again, you know what? For funsies, I'm gonna try it on my lips. This is the first time I'm gonna ever try this color, so I don't know. I don't know how it's gonna be. Let's see. Wait a second. I need to dry my lips. So that's how it is. It's not my color, guys. Oh. All right. It is cute though. It is not my color. That one thing's for sure. I don't know how often will I use this. Oh my gosh. Typically for lipstick, I would go for reach out for peach tones, for neutral or nude tones. That's what I would normally go for. Red, yes. From so long as it's cool red, I would reach out for that. Brick red, I love the color, but it really makes my teeth yellow. I like it a lot though, but it makes my teeth yellow. Very yellow. Lastly, I think if there's a color that I would lean into, bright pink. Yes, exactly. If there's a color that I would lean into, that's Oogie Boogie. Because it is a nude color. Let me go ahead and show you how it looks like. Yeah. There you go. I did show that to you earlier, so let me go ahead and do the swipe. Oh, that's really good. It's not as pigmented as the red and the pink one, but I think it's because it's nude in color. Oh, I don't think this color would work for me though. It is a little bit more nude than what I'm expecting it to be. It looks dark here, but it's not as dark upon application. So that's gonna be a problem for me just because I have dark lips. So I am not sure if this will apply very well to me. I have to like apply it a couple of times, like 3 swipes before I get this kind of pigmentation. One swipe, this is how it's gonna look like with one swipe. So it's not as pigmented, or maybe it's not as dark just because it really is nude in color. So for people like me who have darker skin, or who have morena skin is what they call it in Filipino, morena. It is a little bit tough. You have to be careful with picking out a nude color. You don't want a nude color that's too light because that will make you look like a sick person instead. So, you know, you have to pick the right nude color very well. Might as well try it on the lips. The problem is, that pink color is tinted, by the way. So when I say tinted, it means that the color kind of stays on my lips. So my lips is a little bit pinkish. You know what? Let me try a new wet wipe. Okay. There is still that pink tint. Let's see here. I should have started with this because this one has the lightest color. Oh. nice. But you have, I have to swipe it a couple of times, like 3 times of, like 2 to 3 application before I get this kind of color. The first swipe barely there, so I have to do it a couple of times. It is very creamy though. I love it. It is very creamy. The lipsticks, I love the formulation. It is very creamy. Not matte. Sometimes I would go for matte lipsticks. I like matte colors, but they make my lips really dry. The cream Luxe lipsticks, they are really good in my skin. So I love it. It looks nice. Hey, I love the color. I'm starting, as I'm looking at it, I have my apprehensions. But as I'm looking at it, I'm falling in love more and more on this color. Oh my god. Ooh. Okay, now I'm just looking. I'm just staring at myself. Okay, you know what? Because I've tried both colors on my lips, let me go ahead and try the Jack Skellington one. Since I've already tried both on my lips, let me go ahead and try the Jack Skellington as well. This is one swipe. My god, it's super pigmented. One swipe, man. That is super red. Wait. Store, I want to use these types of this type of red, but it's super pigmented. This is the Hades. What's this Hades lipstick? And this is how it looks like. It is even lighter than the Oogie Boogie, actually. So I love this Hades lipstick though. I love it a lot. I also bought the Snow White Queen, the Queen from Snow White. She's called just the Queen in that lipstick. So anyway, I don't even know Snow White's, the Queen's name, Snow White's grandmother's name. I don't even know. Does it even have a name? Was it ever even mentioned in the story? I don't actually know. That one is matte red and it was super rich in color. Like one swipe and... It's actually almost similar to this. The only difference is that that one's matte. This one's creamy. But you know what? It's not as creamy as the Oogie Boogie. Oogie Boogie is the creamiest. I super love this. And look at that. It's very transferable. Just because they're all cream lipsticks. So don't get me wrong. They're all transferable. Ooh, and it looks like something went wrong with my camera. Did it go on sleep? I think it went on sleep. Alright, it went on sleep. I think there's a settings in there that I can fix so that it doesn't sleep on me. Hold on for a second. I think I need to troubleshoot this. Alright, there you go, I'm back. It went on sleep! That's so dumb! I think there's a settings in there that I have to touch. Alright, now, the collar, the lipstick collar just went everywhere. I have to clean it up. Oh no! Alright, that's what I get. See, that's why I don't like this tripod. Great. Now you guys just saw, or what you just saw earlier is actually my whatchamacallit, my vacuum cleaner. It's my vacuum cleaner for my desktop. Great. I am still filled with nice floor. It's a little bit messy on the floor. Oh, the Sally lipstick really is staying. Like, that one's super pigmented. You can see that it's super pigmented because it's really, you know, tinted, and I'm having a hard time cleaning it up. Oh, shoot. Jesus Christ, are you kidding me? Please don't fail me. Great. Is it giving up on me? Is it like the stream is so long that it's not working anymore? Alright, we'll have to change my setup a little bit. Just because that one's not working on me anymore, we'll just have to make do with my camera. My trusty. I have to play around with this new camera for a little bit more. I haven't really tried it for this long on stream. So, I don't know. Let me take that out first. Yeah, that one's not working for me. The camera is. It's been working well since earlier. I think it. I don't know. I have to research about it for a little bit. Maybe there is a settings that I have. There is a setting that I have to trigger for it to stay longer, or there's probably a driver that I need to update. I am still struggling with the pink collar. Okay, we are going to move on because it's taking quite a while. Alright, you know, I'm not gonna open this up, but this is fairly obvious what it is. These are some bejewel. If you want to bejewel your face, you can. It came in with the package. So one of the things that I haven't really, that I kind of forgot to discuss, are the lipstick. The LOX lipstick holiday decorations, it's $10 each. For the blending sponge, it's $8. The face crystals, this is $8. A little bit expensive, but they're nice. The colors are good. I haven't tried putting crystals on my face. Maybe if I'm feeling a little adventurous, I might try one of these days for like a fantasy look or something. I don't know. I don't really consider myself as a beauty guru. I don't think I'm even good with makeups. So, but you know, hey, maybe I'll try one of these days. And then, what else am I missing? Next top is... what's this? Master of Fright. What's this? Glitterly Obsessed Glitter Gel. So this is their glitter gel. The glitter gel, how much is it? Master of Fright Glitterly Obsessed is for $10, this one. So it's about the same price as their Jelly Much Shadow Trio. This is not... I've seen people actually use this on their eyes. It's not safe in the eyes. People should not use it in their eyes. But you know what? They're using it. I haven't personally... I have one Glitterly Obsessed from the Sailor Moon collection. It was really good. I use it as sort of... here for... whatchamacallit? For... See, I don't even know the name anymore. For a highlighter, I've used it as a highlighter. It was really good. Not for every occasion, not for your everyday look for sure, but hey, I was like trying things out. So let's open this up. We reverted back to our to our old setup, wherein we'll have to rely on this camera, unfortunately. Okay. It does have the same packaging as the lipstick, wherein it has that frosted black plastic, and then you have Jack Skellington's face on the cap, and that's just about it. Pretty simple design, but it's really cute. And I like how they always have this plastic cover to protect the cosmetic, and this is how it looks like. Ooh. It looks like a putty, but you know what? It's better on application. Okay. Based from my review, based from the reviews I've read online, a lot of people were pretty much they were disappointed with this. Just because the design of the glitters are just simple polygon shapes. So they were pretty... Smells nice though. I mean, not super floral or really... But smells nice. A lot of the people were pretty disappointed because, hey, it's Nightmare Before Christmas. Why not like a snowflakes design, right? For the glitters. I mean... their boxes have, and I do kind of agree with them. I understand where they're coming from. Just because, look at the boxes. The boxes here have those black snowflake designs right over there. Not very visible on the camera, but hey, they're there. Why not apply it as well on our Glitterly Obsessed? The Sailor Moon one is really good. It has that star shape. It has those star-shaped designs, the really intergalactic feel. But this one, kind of normal. This is how it looks like. So, it has those polygon shaped crystals. So that's your Glitterly Obsessed. I'm not gonna discuss more on this. There's nothing really much to talk about the Glitterly Obsessed. It's just like their normal formula, and it is really such a bitch to take it off from your hands. The glitters are sticking so well, especially when they dry up. It's not easy to remove them. Yeah, quite disappointing. Even me, who's not really much of a like cosmetic connoisseur. I'm not really much of a beauty guru, but even I kind of felt a little bit disappointed with a Glitterly Obsessed Master of Fright. Hey, but the packaging is nice! Look at that, look at the packaging. They have these black snowflakes. But, that was a missed opportunity. If I do say so myself. Anyway, moving on to the very last. Afro Taco Media, hi, hello, how are you? Welcome back to my stream. Welcome back to my channel, is what I want to say. Hey, but look, that cool blue tone on the red is working. My teeth are whiter. Anyway, moving on to the main show. We have here the palette, the nightmare. Thank you, Afro Taku. We have here the eyeshadow palette, the Nightmare Before Christmas eyeshadow palette. This is a pressed powder. This is similar to how ColourPop has always done their palette. It's always in a pressed powder kind of formula. And it's very pigmented. You cannot expect less from ColourPop. Their eyeshadows are super pigmented. Now, when it comes to color, that's what we're gonna talk about. Oh, okay. Hey, good luck on your studies. Good luck on your exam. Have fun. Have fun with your with revising. Anyway, I don't know how to, you know, but good luck. Thank you so much, Tenshi World. Really enjoy you coming over here. Have fun. Now, this eyeshadow palette goes for $22. Thank you. Goes for $22. And I say that's not a bad price. ColourPop eye palettes are really on a more affordable side. So let me open it up. And the actual palette has the same design as the box. It's really, really cool. I love it. With Zero and Jack on the front. Now, what this palette is lacking is, if I'm not mistaken, it doesn't have a mirror. So let me check. Oh no, it does. My bad, it does have a mirror. There you go. And it's really cool. And the mirror is a little bit thicker right now. Yes, this is an unboxing of the Nightmare Before Christmas collection from ColourPop. So anyway, this is how the palette looked like. It sucks that my other camera gave up just when I'm unboxing this. What I feel kind of bad about is that there's no film covering. Usually there's like a frosted film covering the actual mirror, but this time it doesn't have it. So we'll go straight to the collection, or to the eyeshadow palette now. So we have here, this one is Zero. Let me go ahead and get my brush. Okay, so this one is Zero, and then this is Meant to Be. The names are also right underneath the eyeshadow color as well. This is Meant to Be, and then this is Dear Friend, the one with the embossed snowflake. And then next we have In My Bones. Now, looking at this collection, I kind of see now why a lot of people are complaining about the colors chosen for the Nightmare Before Christmas. They're not as bold and bright as what you expect for a Halloween palette. So that is kind of disappointing, but hey, the packaging is nice. If there's anything you can get out of it, it's a nice package. It's a nice package collection. Though I spent $115 for this, oh my gosh. All right, and then we have here, let's go from the start again. We have here Pumpkin Patch, and then you have the Christmas Town. This is the pink one. And then you have Frog's Breath. Oops, this one here. And then you have Dr. Finkelstein. I kind of am liking the Dr. Finkelstein collar, but it doesn't look as pressed as the other collars. So I'm a little bit iffy to touch it. And this is What's This? Oh my god, one of my favorite theme songs in Nightmare Before Christmas is What's This? What's This? What's This? And This is Halloween. I think those are their two popular songs anyway. And the Jack Skellington solo. And then you have here, what's this? Sandy Claus! This is Sandy Claus! Aww. And then you have here Everybody Scream. And then we have the Halloween Town. The last color. Now, I am just wondering. Chotto. Now, it is cruelty-free, but it does have a warning, not safe for use in the immediate area. There's a fair warning in here. It's in a very fine print. I have to try it on my skin before I can pick the color that I like. But so far as the lipsticks are concerned, I kind of like this Oogie Boogie Luxe lipstick. It is nude in color and it's super creamy. Love, love it. I also love both of the eyeliners. They're really good. Now, there are some in here. Fair warning, there are some. I don't know if it's visible. My camera is not focusing in. There are some colors, like for example, the Christmas Town would have an asterisk to them, as well as Sandy Claus and what's this? Yeah, what's this? So there is a fine print in here that says not safe for immediate eye use. So you might want to use them a little bit farther away from the eye. I am not sure what's the reason why it's like that. Oh, and Everybody's Scream also has the warning. Why is it though? I am not sure why those aren't safe. Is it because they're actually luminous? Because I've seen before in their marketing that some of the colors are actually luminous. I think that's the gimmick of this eyeshadow palette. And not a lot of influencers are mentioning that. So I can't be sure if my guess is right. And I think that's also the reason why there's a fair warning in here that they're not safe for, you know, immediate eye use. I have to experiment about these colors a little bit. So, but because they're not safe for eye use, maybe it's not, I wouldn't use them yet on the eye. Rather, I will be swatching them. Sorry though, I think I'm gonna be swatching them on my other arm just because this arm is already filled with glitter and I can't get out that pink lipstick from the Sally lipstick, Luxe lipstick. I can't get it out. I can't get it off for some reason. Alright, let's go ahead and try Zero. Let me just make sure that I don't have glitters. Quite busy. I've been taking up Nihongo classes. How about you? That's why I haven't streamed for quite a while. I've been inactive in social on Twitch just because I've been taking Nihongo classes on my weekends and then I have work on weekdays. So, you know, a little bit hard to balance my work life, to be honest. My work life and study. How about you, Afro Taco Media? How are you? How have you been doing? Alright, this is... it's white. Oh, is it silver? This is silver! Oh, okay, Zero is like silvery white. I've been filming and editing. Ooh, that's nice. What have you been filming? Alright, just a quick update on the... Jack Skellington lipstick. It's not as creamy and buttery. It is kind of buttery upon application, but it dries up pretty quickly, which makes me think it's not a full cream lipstick. But I tried it right now. It's fully dry, but I tried it right now. It still is pretty much transferable. Not as transferable as earlier, because earlier just a little touch and it transferred, the color transfers to your skin. But right now, it still is a little bit transferable, but not so much. Finding out I have anxiety and it triggers... oh, that sucks! What triggers your anxiety? Stress. So anyway, let me go ahead and swipe this real quick. Look at that. Expect ColourPop to be super pigmented. I'm not just good with swiping, you guys. I'm probably dumb when it comes to swiping, but look at how pigmented is that. This is really cool. The N5 classes are on weekends. would be nice, really, as it would not. Yes, there are. Lyceum offers schedules on weekdays and weekends. I picked the weekends because it's gonna be tough to juggle the work and study during weekdays. So that's why I picked the weekends. But it's 4 to 5 hours every weekend, like 8 hours in total. So Saturdays and Sundays, you have 4 hours each on Saturdays and Sundays. So this is zero. It's silvery white. Lake festivals and events. Oh, okay, got it. Next, we have Meant to Be. This one is gray. My God, will I be ever using a gray color on my face? Probably not. But here's the swipe. It barely registers on my skin color. Let me fix that a little bit. Please expect fallout on this one. This is a powder matte. So please expect fallout on this type of eyeshadow palette. It barely registers on my skin, but let me see here. Let me try that again on my palm. This is how it looks like on a white surface or a flesh surface. Yeah, maybe for cosplay. Yes, that probably contributed to me getting low scores. Yeah, probably. It's most likely that because, you know, you can focus on study. So, yeah, they do have weekend schedules. So, that's the gray color. It's more like ash, if you'll ask me. This feels very ashy. That is Meant to Be. I actually feel bad swiping on the Dear Friend just because it has that embossed snowflake design. But let's go ahead and dive into it. This one is dark chocolate brown, or chocolate brown, not dark. I don't know how much will it register on my skin, but let's see. Oh, it does register quite well. This is good for if you want to deepen colors, like if you want to go for that smoky look. This is a good foundation for it, I feel like. Normally, if I would like to use a light color, like let's say peach or coral, and then I would normally darken it with a brown eyeshadow, I feel like this is a good brown. This is a cool brown, by the way. Cool gray and cool brown. So it has it's lacking. If you're looking for a warmer tone, this is not it for you. So maybe I would blend this more with a bluish tone when I'm doing eyeshadow colors, or when I'm going for that smoky effect for an eyeshadow. Nihongo class, not Nihon class. Nihongo class, doing great. I'm happy with my N5, graduated N5. Now I moved on to N4. I have a little bit of reservations towards my new N4 teacher. Just because he likes to train in a very hurried pace, like he's always in a hurry. We just started though last Sunday, so I'm gonna give him a benefit of a doubt. Last time we were supposed to end by 5:30, and he ended the class an hour and a half earlier. It's fine for early dismissal. I'm all right with that. But that's super early for me, like 1.5 hours. It just felt like he cut corners there. So, you know, I have a little bit of reservations, but we'll see. Next color is In My Bones. This one is dark gray. And this is where I'm getting why influencers are kind of disappointed with the colors, just because they're all in the like gray tones. That's the dark gray. Let me see it here on my, this is how it looks like on my palm. That's a dark matte gray for you. Ash matte. This is dark gray matte. And this is where I'm getting. So far, we're getting subtle colors here. Nothing too bold. this is where I'm sort of understanding the influencers who are not very happy with this collection. And maybe it's because of the colors, but so far I'm not getting it. It looks solid, but I'm not getting the colors that I want, just because, you know, it doesn't, I don't think it worked. They work well on my skin, except for the silver, the 0.0, the zero I like, silver. Hey Potato, what's up? How are you? I miss you. Thank you so much for dropping by. Yeah, I know. I finally found the time. Oh my god. Okay, next we have the pumpkin patch. The pumpkin patch. Can't even talk properly now. So this is the pumpkin patch. It is a it is a plain gold color. And again, it doesn't register well in my skin. But this is how it looks like on my palm. It's not working well on my skin just because of my skin color. Let me go ahead and make a second swipe for that. There you go. That's the pumpkin patch. And this is how my finger looks like. It's really gold. It's really golden. I guess it's a nice topper. You can use this, I feel like you can use this as a topper on your eyelid when you want to make another color shine. Gold. I think this is a good topper color. Next is the Christmas Town. The Christmas Town is your hot pink. This is very similar to what's the name of that? Jelly. In a pressed powder form, think of it as the jelly eyeshadow that we've tackled earlier, the Shock Jelly Eyeshadow. This is essentially the same color. So let me go ahead and swipe it. Okay, that's a little more subtle than I expected. The jelly shadow is more pigmented than this. So let me go ahead and try for a second swipe. Okay, now it's more pigmented. The colors are not really, you know, that in your face kind of color. So far, they've been very subtle. And I don't know. Frog's Breath is very similar as well to the jelly eyeshadow color. It's that midnight color again. So, why are we repeating colors, ColourPop? You already have this. Oh, it is not. It's brownish. It's purplish in color, actually. It's not. It's showing as brown. It's registering as brown in my camera, but it actually has that purple flex to it. It is on the dark plum purple side, right? It is plum purple. It has a plum color. This one is plum. My bad. It's not similar to the jelly eyeshadow. This one is plum. Man, I'm bad with colors. Now, this is with Dr. Finkelstein. This is the color I'm most interested in. Ooh, that looks really good. It's a blue-violet color. Oh my god. Let me go ahead and swipe that. Not as pigmented as well. Alright, I thought it would be bolder. But it wasn't. Aww. Let me try for a second swipe. Alright, that is a little bolder. You know what? I like the color. I like the color. It has a blue-violet color. It is a blue-violet color. I like it. Not as pigmented as I wanted it to be. You have to do a couple of swipes for you to get that kind of pigmentation that you want. But hey, we'll have to make do with what we have. Okay, moving on to the third row. We have here, what's this? I thought at first that what's this is matte, an orange matte, but it actually has some flecks of glitters to them. Not as glittery as the second row of eyeshadows, but this one is that matte with glitter. And let me go ahead and try. Aww, the face got erased. That's sad. Well, let me go ahead and try this one. It looks pretty pigmented on my finger, but let's see here. How will it register? Oh, that's the most pigmented color by far. I am pretty impressed. When will I use an orange eyeshadow? I don't know, but hey, that's the most pigmented one so far, and I'm quite impressed. Again, that's what's this. Okay. And it has those, not very visible in the camera, but it has those golden glitter, flecks of golden glitters. Very small in size, but it's there. Next is Sandy Claus. Sandy Claus is your matte Barbie pink. This is Barbie pink, right? Let's see here. It looks quite pigmented, but we'll see how it looks like. Not as pigmented. So it looks pigmented on the finger, but not as pigmented when you swipe it. So that's your Barbie pink. Matte Barbie pink. Next is a matte plum. But more, sorry, my bad. Not plum, but this is violet. So this is violet. Ooh, that's pigmented. She's pigmented. That's violet. She's pigmented. I love this one. But I feel like it's a color I've already seen before, though. That's violet because it has those pinkish warm. It's leaning towards the warmer tone. So a lot of people would tend to interchange purple and violet. But from what I've understood, purple colors are more on the bluer side. It has the blue tint, whereas for violet it has the red tint. This is violet. This is more purplish. Okay, so that's the difference between the two. Yeah, orange seems to show the most, followed by this one. This one is really pigmented as well. One swipe and it does the job. Last but not the least, this is Halloween Town. Oh man, that's super pigmented. This one is the midnight color, similar to the jelly eyeshadow that we've tried earlier. And this is how it will look like. Oh my god, that is pigmented as hell. Oh, that's really good. And unlike the orange, unlike the what's this, this one you can actually see. Oh, ugh. This color, the Midnight Town, you can actually see the glitters on them. Look at that. It looks really pretty. I love it. This is the Midnight color. It's really dark midnight blue with blue flecks of blue. I can do this. Blue glitters. So really, really, really cool. And as you can see, I'm not very good with swipes, unlike other influencers who are doing this way better than I do. I am not really much of a beauty guru, but that is it. This palette contains 12 eyeshadow colors. So there you go. Those are all the 12 eyeshadow colors. Hold on for a second. Ugh. Okay, sorry about that. Just a message. Alright, I am filled with glitters, and unfortunately for my keyboard, oh my god, my Corsair keyboard is also filled with glitters. Huh.
That is not fun. I know, right? It's my phone's notification. Oh no, I feel bad for my keyboard. No, not my keyboard. Well, hopefully when I clean it later, I'll be able to remove the glitters on my keyboard. Anyway, I feel haggard, and that is it for the ColourPop collection. Overall, that's $115. If you buy them per retail eyeshadow palette, $22. Jelly Much eyeshadow trio, $10 each, but there are three of them, so you kind of have to buy 30. You have to spend $30 for that. What's your favorite color, Light Ranger? Of course, it's pink. Pink and red. Red Ranger is always my favorite in all Sentais. Red Ranger is always my favorite. From time to time, there's pink, just because if we're talking about the US, the American Power Ranger, Kimberly is my favorite character. That's why, hence, I like Pink Ranger. But overall, if we're talking about the Japanese Sentais, always Red Ranger. Aka Ranger desu ne. All right. I am quite tired. All right. Ha, Super Sentai. I do like watching Super Sentai. Recently, I haven't been watching Super Sentai, I must admit. As well as other tokusatsu films or tokusatsu series like Kamen Riders. I haven't been watching them and I haven't been updated. The last... Kimberly only, though. Yeah, I know Kimberly. I love Kimberly. The last Super Sentai I've watched... What was the last Super Sentai I've watched? Oh, it's not the latest Super Sentai, but the last Sentai that Super Sentai that I've watched was Magi Ranger. But it's not the latest one. It's an old Super Sentai, but I kind of have to backtrack a little bit because I skipped on the Magi Ranger, so I've watched it. Anyway, going back, the Luxe Lipstick, it's $10 each. BFF Liquid Liners, $10 each. Master of Fright, Glitterly Obsessed, it's $10. The Blending Sponge, $8. And the Face Crystals, it's $8 as well. So overall, that's $115 when I bought it from ColourPop. Now, I love the collection as a whole. I don't exactly know if I have a lot of use on the eyeshadow palette, but the packaging for me alone is a winner. So there. What are my favorites in the collection? Alright. My first favorite will be the Oogie Boogie Luxe Lipstick. This is super creamy. I love it. I love it on my lips. It felt really nice, so that is super cool. Second most favorite will be the eyeliners. I love the Scream Queen eyeliner, the Sally eyeliner, Scream Queen. I super love this. And then also this is a good white eyeliner. I don't know how often will I use it, but it's nice. So yeah. If there's anything that you're gonna buy in the collection, I would recommend the lipsticks. They're really nice. The colors, I wouldn't recommend a color because the color that you want would be dependent on you. This is the lipstick that I'm using right now is the Jack Skellington one. Sally's Hot Pink. And this one, these are my two favorites. Da-da-da, there you go. Those are my two favorites. Alright! Now, I am not... before we end the stream, I've been streaming for 2 hours. Before we end the stream, I can see that some people are coming in. So, hi, everyone. For those people who are in here, my name is Lady Falatriel. And this one is a little bit of... I wouldn't say new. This is like the second time I unbox a makeup collection. The first one was a long time ago when I did the Sakura... Cardcaptor Sakura unboxing. I did that. So yeah, this is the second time I did a makeup collection unboxing. I would normally play games. I would play RPG games like Genshin Impact, Monster Hunter. What else? I am drawing a blank right now just because I feel like I'm tired. Anyway, bonus unboxing! I bought this. I didn't buy this along with the collection, but this is a tarot deck. Now, just a heads up, I am not a tarot reader. I did practice a little bit of cartomancy some years ago, but that is a... But what I read before was... Oracle deck. That's what they're called. They're called oracle deck. So that's what I used to read before. Now, this one... Funny story. Last Saturday, I went to Fully Booked, which is a bookstore here in the Philippines. It's a popular bookstore here in the Philippines. So I kind of went there just to buy some gift wraps for the Christmas, for holidays, right? I bought some Christmas with other Christmas gift wraps with other, you know, gift wrapping stuff like a ribbon and all that shiz. So I went there, and as I passed by their like card section, because the Fully Booked has this tarot card section, I spotted this. This is the only box left, and being a sucker for the Nightmare Before Christmas, I bought it without any hesitation. So there, even though I don't read and I probably won't use this I don't think I'm ever gonna go back to cartomancy, just because it gave me... I used to have, when I started practicing cartomancy, it was good and all, but then again I started having these dreams, some of them are even nightmares, so it wasn't good for me, and so I stopped. That's the main reason why I stopped doing cartomancy. But this one though, tarot deck. So I don't know if I'm gonna use this. I bought this for collection. That's why my friend told me, hey, if you didn't buy it for use, just, you know, buy it for the art. So that's what I did. I bought it for the art. I am such a sucker for these types of things. For anything that's Nightmare Before Christmas. So yeah. Let's go ahead and unbox this. This is still sealed. I just bought it last Saturday. This goes for 1,200 pesos in Fully Booked. How much is that in dollars? That's around 20-ish dollars, $22, right? $24. There you go. It's around $24. No, so not bad. And let's go ahead and open her up. Oh, it's 1,250 pesos. Woo! It looks nice. The box looks nice. So this is the front. You have here, you know, the Nightmare Before Christmas tarot deck with the guidebook. So if you really want to learn, if for example, I want to go back to cartomancy, there is a guidebook in here that I can use. And then towards the back, there are some explanations, some sample cards that you can see in the... inside, and then you have zero in here, so really, really cute. On the side, you just have, you know, the Nightmare Before Christmas, the tarot deck and guidebook, and the inside of the box when you open it, this is also the first time that I'm seeing this. So you have here, ooh, it's color purple, I love it. So you have here, this is their guidebook, and it has that little lace in here, or a little ribbon to help you pull it out. And this is how thick the guidebook is. So at the back you have Jack and Sally. It really looks nice. I love this. Oh my god. And then yeah, you have here the... I love the smell of new books, right? I love the smell. Sometimes I like buying books just because I love the smell of new books. Anyway, this is how it looks like. So you have here, you know, it's gonna explain to you what are the different cards, what do they stand for, their meanings, etc. But a good cartomancy or a good card reader don't need a guidebook. They need it, you know, just to study for general purposes. But usually when they do card reading, I've seen people who are good at card reading, they really don't need a guidebook. They would usually interpret it as how they see the cards. Now, the card itself, this is a lot. This is how thick it is. How many cards are there? Even the inside of the box is really cool. The design is really nice. Oh, there you go. There's a price. There's a US price. It's $24.99 in the US and $33.99 for Canadian dollars. If I think this is sold in Canada as well. Manufactured in China. It doesn't say. Oh, there you go. 78 cards, and the guidebook is 128 pages. So there you go. You have Jack. I don't think I'm gonna like spread this one by one, but it seems like these are the different characters. So Jack is the fool. Wow, he's the fool. I remember watching. It's not Katekyo Hitman Reborn, but it's that anime where they're a mafia anime, and one of them is like the fool, and he's like the trump card of the group. I can't remember the title. Anyway, this is Sally. Sally is the high priestess. Alright, then. Yeah, I'm not gonna go through it. The mayor is the Hierophant. Or is it Hierophant? I'm actually not sure with the pronunciation. Of course, the lovers. Jack and Sally, so sweet. Ooh, Santa Claus, not... Oh, Sandy Claus! This is Sandy Claus, the chariot in the sled. In this, not sled, but sleigh. Yeah, should I go over it very quickly? But there's like 78 cards in here. So I'm probably not gonna go over one by one. Ooh, look at this. This is cool. Santa Claus. The actual Santa Claus. Ooh, oogie boogie. But yeah, the art looks really nice. It doesn't. Who's the artist for this? It's definitely not Tim Burton. Did they commission a different artist? It doesn't say. So it is probably an official Tim Burton art. It's just that Sally looks a little bit different. Right? This is not... Is this like Tim Burton art? Anyway. Where am I from? I'm from the Philippines. This is how the back of the card looks like, by the way. Yeah. So, I'm keeping this for collection purposes. Whether I'll practice cartomancy again, I honestly do not know. I had a bad experience before, and I don't know if I want to go through that again, or if I'll suffer through those nightmares again when I started practicing cartomancy. Oh, you're from Ohio. Hey, good morning. It's nighttime here in the Philippines, so I know it's morning there in Ohio. Anyway, that is it for my unboxing. So we did unbox the Nightmare Before Christmas Color Pop Collection, and then we had an extra or special unboxing of the tarot cards that I got last Saturday. I hope you guys enjoyed my unboxing video. Sorry I couldn't give a lot of descriptions on the... whatchamacall this, the palette. I'm just really not good with it, I guess. So I don't know if I'll go ahead and continue with unboxing makeup collections in the future, but please look forward to me unboxing toys. I do have a lot of toys that I haven't unboxed recently just because I'm super busy. So just to give you an idea, I have a lot of Nendoroid toys that I haven't unboxed. I have the Lego video. I have the Marvel collection or the Marvel series of Lego minifigures that I haven't opened up. And then, what else? I have the Shoot. I can't remember the other stuff. I have the Sylvanian family. I have the Sylvanian family. I don't know from which collection is that, but I think it's the Carnival collection that I haven't unboxed. And that's been with me for quite a while. It's really because I want to add more content on my stream. I want to do a lot of unboxing. I just haven't really found the time, especially with my Nihongo class. So hopefully I'll be doing more of those during the Christmas holiday. I did file a couple days of leave during the Christmas holiday, most especially. So please look forward of more unboxing videos from when I stream on those dates. Alright, for now, I don't have any regular schedule yet because my Nihongo class will be until next year. It will go for 4 more months, so I'm not sure if I'll be able to squeeze more times when I'm back on my regular schedule, you know, when I have work and then I have my Nihongo class. I see the fan blowing. Yeah, I know, there's a fan. I did turn off my aircon just because it's a little bit colder at night right now, just because it's the Burmont, so my aircons are usually turned off at night. So I have my fan on though. Anyway, that is it for me. I'm gonna go ahead and end the stream for today. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna try to stream games this week. Can I? Oh, thank you so much. That really fills my heart. I'm so happy to be talking to more people. And for those who followed me today, Cannon Bridge, thank you for the follow. Determined Hero and Squishy Hero, thank you so much for the raid. Really do appreciate it. Afro Tackle Media, thank you for being with me on the stream. Tiny Christy, Patete and Star Creek, thank you so much for dropping by, as well as Tenshi World. And Koopsmander, thank you. Oh, Patete, hello! Yeah, I'll try to stream games this week. Patete, there's an update in Phasmophobia. Game ba? GGGDG! Have I updated? When's the update in Phasmophobia? Yes! Sige, let's schedule probably Friday. I filed a leave on Friday, so let's try Phasmophobia. I don't know if nag-update na siya. Let's check. But I know there's an update. I think there's like cursed items. That's one of the major updates in the upcoming Phasmophobia. Okie dokes. Yes. Same to you, Tiny Christy. Thank you so much. And hopefully, try out. Check Lyceum Makati. They have their own Facebook page. See if you would like to enroll in their classes. As always. So, what time are you awake, Patete? Around this time? Okay. Yeah, we can stream around this time since that's the time you're awake. And then Oppa also comes home around 7 p.m. Philippine time. So I guess this is the perfect time for us to stream Phasmophobia. Okay, let's do it on Friday. Yay! So guys, my next stream, I think it's pretty much settled. Friday, Phasmophobia. Wag lang kaming tutulugan ni Patete. Alright guys! Thank you so much for being here. Stay safe, everyone. The pandemic is not yet over, so I hope that everyone is safe and sound. Please be more careful and practice social distancing. That's it for me today. Have a great day, everyone. Love you all. Bye-bye. I still have the swatches here. I have to clean it up. Anyway, bye-bye, everyone. Good night. And for the people who are in different parts of the world, good morning and good afternoon. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Thank you.
feels heavy on your chest. I wish I could carry the weight all on my back.